Get gains in up markets, but don't lose in down markets. In this episode, I'm going to address the question, how can I protect my money from a stock market crash? I'll share with you the most dynamic strategy that is so powerful, so simple, and yet you're going to be asking yourself, how come I've never heard about this before? It is so sad that most financial advisors, CPAs and tax attorneys that I have mentored were sitting there with their mouths open when I taught them this. My name's Doug Andrew, and I've helped people optimize their financial assets and minimize unnecessary taxes for more than 4.5 decades. Now, let me give you a little bit of my background and story so that you'll understand where I'm coming from. I actually started as a financial strategist, helping people optimize financial assets in 1974. And from 1974 until 1980, in just 6 short years, I was responsible for more than 3,000 clients in 13 Western states. And I was trying to do my best. I was helping them put money in a diversified portfolio of mutual funds. And it was sort of like helping them make sure that we could get an average return of hopefully 12%. Now, actually, we did a pretty good job of that, but it was like playing red light, green light, if you ever did that as a kid. Sometimes we were progressing as much as 20%, but then we had to take several steps back and forward and back. I've often described the stock market as like a person with a yo-yo, hopefully walking up some stairs, that it's going to grow over time. But I'm going to give you some examples of where we've had 10-year periods where that person with a yo-yo was walking across a flat surface. The Dow Jones, the Russell 2000, the S&P 500 was exactly where it was 10 years earlier. And how our clients have doubled and even tripled their money during periods like that. But see, I started out as a traditional financial planner trying to help people in the market. I also realized that even if I could earn for my clients an average of 12%, that's not what they were netting to buy gas and groceries at the end of the day. Because let's say you have $1 million nest egg and it's earning 12%. That would be $120,000 a year. If you pull out $120,000 of interest, okay, or gain as income, you got to pay tax on that. Between federal and state tax, most people with that kind of money will pay at least a third. So if you pull out $120,000, you pay $40,000 in tax, you're only netting $80,000 to buy gas and groceries. A lot of asset managers charge at least 1% in asset management fees. So that's another $10,000. So if you earn 12%, you're only netting 7% or $70,000. That all changed in 1980. And my clients were never happier than when I got them out of the volatile market and I had them earn rates of return more predictable in the 8 to 10% range, totally tax-free. I was trying really hard to earn my clients an average of 12%. But like I said, it's like red light, green light. Sometimes they earn more than that. Sometimes they would take steps backwards because their money was in a volatile market. Well, Dalbar, who studies investor behavior and stock market actual performance, has said that over any 20-year period in American history since the Great Depression, if you just leave your money put, okay, you don't buy and sell at the wrong times, if you just left it put, you would probably average around 9.14%. It's a little over 9%. That's before tax. So if your money is in a tax-deferred IRA or 401k and you're earning 9%, you're only netting in a 33% tax bracket 6%. Let's say you have $1 million nest egg, it's earning 9%. Theoretically, you could pull out $90,000 without depleting your principal, but you have to pay tax on $90,000 between federal and state tax, a third. Many Californians even pay more than that. So you pay $30,000 in tax, you're only netting $60,000 to buy gas and groceries. Well, the big problem is Maybe you think you can get by on $60,000 a year in retirement or $5,000 a month. With the real rate of inflation, which is normally between 7 to 10% with prescription costs, medical costs, and so forth, the cost of living doubles every 7 to 10 years. The purchasing power of the dollar, in other words, is cut in half. So if you could get by on $5,000 a month now, probably in 7 to 10 years, you're going to need $10,000 a month to buy the same gallons of gas and loaves of bread that $5,000 a month used to buy. And this is what causes people to outlive their money when they don't take into consideration taxes and inflation. So it's the market volatility that sometimes causes people to earn less than even 6% net rates of return. Dalbar said the average investor in the market only really earns about 3.5%, 3.49 to be precise. Why? Because they're buying and selling at the wrong times. Emotion comes into play. People see their money in the market and then we have a serious nosedive like happened in February, March of 2020 because of COVID-19. The market went down 33%. When people see their money dwindle in value to 30, 35, 40%, they panic and they go, enough already, and they sell low. And then they wait till the market comes back, and then they buy high. Now, you have institutional investors that play off of that. They know that's what the public's going to do. So Dalbar says the average retiree, because of having money in the market and they get emotionally involved, only really earned 3.5%. So this is what precipitated the 4% rule in the financial services industry. Do you know that most financial advisors, if you have money in the market in your IRAs or 401ks, they only want you to take out 4% a year and a payout because they don't want to be sued for you outliving your money. You have to sign a waiver if you pull out more than 4%. That's pretty pathetic. 4% means on $1 million nest egg, you're only going to pull out $40,000 a year. You have to pay tax on that. Even in a 25% bracket, you're netting $30,000. A lot of these money managers charge 1% in fees on the entire million. That's another 10 grand. If you subtract taxes and fees, you pull out 40,000, you're netting 20,000 to buy gas and groceries, 2%. How pathetic is that? I'm going to show you how you could have 8%, 80,000 tax free. How much more is 80,000 than 40,000? It's double. How much more is it than 20,000 net? It's 4 times as much retirement income. The best way to protect your money, especially from a crash in the market, is by not having your money in the market. You want to link your returns to what happens in the market, but you don't want to have any of the risk that actually people incur by having money directly in the market. People go, so how do you do that? It's called indexing, and I will explain how indexing works here in just a moment. But a lot of people don't realize that when you experience a 25% loss, okay, let's use $1 million nest egg because that's a round number. If $1 million suffers a 25% loss, you're down to $750,000. Now, to make up for a 25% loss, you have to have a 33% gain. People go, huh? No, see, what does 750,000 have to grow by? 33%. 33% of 750,000 is 250 grand. A 25% loss has to be followed by a 33% gain to get back your money. Well, a lot of people in February, March of the year 2020, because of COVID-19, saw their nest egg dwindle in value 33% in like 30 days. Now, I've seen people lose 40% in a year in 2008, and it took 4 years to make that back. Because if you lose 33%, you have to have a 50% gain. If $1 million goes down to 667,000, that has to have a 50% increase to come back to break even. You wouldn't believe how many people in 2008 lost 50%. $1 million nest egg goes down to 500,000. If you have a 50% loss, it has to be followed by a 100% gain to get back to break even. Just eliminate the losses in the first place. How do you do that? Let me share with you how this is done. Now, Warren Buffett has two rules of investing. Rule number one, don't lose money. Rule number two, don't forget rule number one. Now, easier said than done, but one of my favorite strategies to protect my money from market crashes is indexing. So in my various books, I talk about indexing. It's a complicated topic, but I'm going to simplify it right now because I accumulate my money in a diversified portfolio of laser funds. Now, I'm just going to use one laser fund to show you how this works. And whether you are socking away $500 a month and you do it for 30 years, it will probably grow to over $1 million. Or whether you started out with $500,000 and in 7 years it doubled to $1 million. I've had many clients using laser funds that started out with $500,000 and it doubled to $1 million in 7 to 10 years. The $1 million doubled to $2 million, the $2 million doubled to $4 million, and the $4 million doubled to $8 million in 30 years. Every 7.5 years it doubled because they were earning average rates of return as high as 10%. It's just math. Now they have $8 million and it's totally tax-free. They can pull out $600,000, $800,000 a year and never deplete their principal. Most of them could never spend that much money in a year and the rest of their life. So you don't want to outlive your money. Sadly, most people have their hard-earned money at risk in the market. Wall Street was never built to give you predictable income. If you ask an advisor with your money on Wall Street, when is the best time to sell? Their answer is always never. They cannot show you predictable cash flow. In other words, what you maybe did for your retirement savings is not necessarily what you should do at retirement. For retirement strategies are totally different than what you do at retirement for your planning, okay? So you want to get out of the market. You want to use indexing. Indexing is where you have your money in a very safe institution, in institutions that have weathered the Great Depression with flying colors. You have your money in their general account portfolio. I'm talking about the multi-trillion dollar insurance industry. This is where banks put 30 to 40% of your money when you deposit it in the bank. The bank pays you 1% interest. They turn around and make 4 or 5% by putting it into insurance companies. You can bypass the middleman, okay? So if I have $1 million in my laser fund with these highly rated insurance companies, I can settle for 5%, let's say, their general account portfolio rate. That's $50,000 anytime I want. Or, and if I take it out, by the way, it's tax-free. Or anytime I feel bullish about America, I can link what they're paying me to an index that they offer. Now, many insurance companies offer indices like the S&P 500, the Dow Jones, the Russell 2000. I can diversify and link to several. I could have 20% of my money linked to the Dow Jones, 20% to the S&P, 20% to the Russell 2000, but let's just be simple here. If I have my million linked to the S&P and it goes up 10%, they'll pay me 10%. If it goes up 15%, they'll pay me 15%, up to a cap. They cap me because they cannot use my $1 million in the market. So how can they afford to pay me that? I'm relinquishing the interest on my million. In this case, I'm talking about 5%. That's $50,000. You can do whatever you need to do with my $50,000 of interest you're earning on my million. And so they buy upside options in that index. That gives them the wherewithal that if the market goes up, they can pay you 10 or 15% because the options double or triple in value. If the economy tanks, if there's a crash, if there's a terrorist attack, I don't lose my million. The options expire worthless. Now, if this is arousing curiosity, I've only scratched the surface. So I want you to learn more. I have several educational videos on this topic, but I want you to read my book, The Laser Fund, and you'll understand how indexing can protect you from market crashes, but you get to participate when the market goes up without the risk. So as I summarize in this episode how you can protect your money from a stock market crash, I want you to learn about indexing. It's amazing how many financial advisors don't have a clue what I'm talking about. They think I'm talking about indexed mutual funds. No. I can usually stump most traditional advisors by talking about making money when the market goes up, but not losing a dime when the market goes down. You're linking your returns. And when I say linking, they're going, "What are you talking about? What do you mean linking? My money is not invested in the market." Well, then how is that insurance company able to afford to pay you what the market does? Because I am indexing. I am giving up the interest on my nest egg for them to buy upside options where they have the wherewithal to pay me 10%, 15%, maybe with multipliers as much as 25, 50% when the market goes up. But if the market goes down, I don't lose a dime of the principal I started with that year. Simply, the options expire worthless. It is so simple, but so many advisors are never taught this because, frankly, they make money by churning your money in the market by buying and selling. So most broker-dealers, most of these financial firms don't want their advisors to know about this because it's management unintensive. They want to charge you management fees. Folks, this is the most inexpensive way and most powerful way to protect yourself. So if you want to learn more of the nitty-gritty about indexing and how it works, I would strongly recommend you read and study this book, subscribe to this channel, search other videos because I teach a lot of different ways about indexing. But if you want to claim your free copy of this 300-page book that has all kinds of charts and graphs and stories, it's actually two books in one. This is the right brain side. This is the left brain side, okay? Simply go to laserfund.com, laserfund.com. You contribute a nominal amount toward the shipping and handling, and I will cover the rest of that cost, and I will pay for the book and fire you out a free copy. And there's also options in there if you like to listen and learn or watch and learn also. But this is the beginning of your brighter future when you can take advantage of gains when the market is up, but not lose when the market goes down.